All right, knife updates. So let's go in here. We'll just grab a cube 3D, drag it on our canvas, go into edit mode, make it a poly mesh 3D. If I turn on my poly frame to see it better, I'm going to go to skin shader 4. And if I, you know, want to get rid of this polarized cap, or if I want to even the geometry out, if I make a change to the overall size through scaling, just hit W and then scale it on down. You can go in here to geometry, zero mesher. I'm going to say half, adaptive size down to 0 for nice even quads, detect edges, hit zero mesh. That'll give me nice even geometry. It'll even crease my edges for me. So I can hit Q to go back in draw mode. Hit Control D a couple times, or just hit divide, delete lower. Then you have a nice cool piece of geometry to use as our canvas for our knife brushes. So if I hold down Control Shift, I can switch to knife curve, which is what, you know, just a refresher. Knife curve, basically, if you hold down Control Shift and drag out, this is a curve stroke. Anything to the right of that gradient where the gradient's heading will be sliced out. Of course, you can hold down Control Shift, and then when you drag out a line, you can let go of Control Shift, hold down Spacebar, and move this or move your line around. You can Alt tap once to do a bendy curve or a Bezier curve, Alt tap twice to do a sharp curve, and of course, you can mix and match these however you'd like. When you let go, it'll slice through your object. But if you wanted to go through here and hold down Control Shift and then try to do a rectangle, you could try to do it, but it may not be perfect. That's where if you hold down Control Shift, going into knife rect comes into play. So if you select this one, what it's doing is it's swapping out your curve stroke with a rectangle stroke. So now that we have the rectangle stroke selected with this brush, we can go through here and just slice through rectangle strokes. If we switch this over to, say, knife circle, you're going to see this circle stroke is on there, and now we can go through there and use a circle stroke to knife through. Now you're going to see neither of these are constrained, so they're a one-to-one ratio. They're, you know, you can make an elongated rectangle or a circle. What you can do is you can go in here to square, and that will snap it to, or constrain it to, a perfect circle. And you could even say circle center, or square center, I'm sorry. So you can go through here, and again, you can move this around, hold down Control Shift, drag it out, like hold down space bar, and then knife through, again, drawn out from the circle. Now, another really cool thing, if I undo all that, if we hold down Control Shift and we'll head on back over to the knife curve, if we slice through here and then we hold down Alt, instead of going from the line to the gradient and slicing and cutting, it'll do the opposite. It'll just cut out the other side. However, if you hold down Control Shift and then space bar, you can turn on B radius, which is your brush radius. So now when I go through here and slice through, it's going to leave behind a piece of geometry here that is the same size as that focal shift of my brush, that little inner circle. So that is going to dictate if I tap S on my keyboard and make that bigger and then slice through, it's going to leave behind a larger cut. Of course, if I make this smaller, it'll leave behind a smaller cut. Another cool thing is if you go through here and you slice through and you hold down Alt before you let go, it won't leave behind that geometry. It'll actually remove that geometry. And if you do this and you stop in the middle, it'll respect that gap. So it won't cut all the way through. It'll stop there. So a really easy way to go through and slice your meshes. Of course, you can do the same thing with these other knife brushes. For example, knife circle, you can go through here. And again, we still have B radius. So if I hold down Control Shift and hold down space bar, brush radius is still selected. So again, if you hold down Control Shift and then hold down Alt, it'll leave that gap behind. If you hold down Control Shift and don't hold down Alt, it'll cut through this geometry, respect those gaps, and leave this geometry behind. So definitely use brush radius to your advantage as needed. Now, you may be thinking, and then hold down Control Shift, spacebar, turn off brush radius, can I go through and slice a circle through? Well, just like when we were using clip circle, if you don't know what clip circle is, you can use this as a clip brush. So you hold down Control Shift and then hold down Alt, it'll push that geometry back to the border of the circle. It's not slicing or removing any geometry. It's just literally pushing that back to the edge of the circle shape. You can't, you know, you can hold down Control Shift and push all that geometry to a circle, but you can't hold down Control Shift and Alt and then cut a hole through here. There's other ways to do that. A couple ways off the top of my head here is we can open up DynaMesh, and here's another feature that's new. You can drag off the resolution or the picker button, and then you can select this and it'll dial in your DynaMesh resolution. So when you turn that on, it'll maintain that same resolution. You can go in here to BI, brush insert, IMM primitives, hit M as in Michael on your keyboard, go to insert cylinder. I'm gonna hold down Alt when I drag this, and if I drag down without letting go, it'll make it a thinner shape. I'll hit W, I'll push this on through, control drag again. and now we have a hole. And now if I use clip circle right here, and you know what, let's do this, control shift circle, we're going to do square center, so I can just go from the middle here. If I hold down alt here, it'll push that geometry out. And now that I say that, you can actually go up here, there is a clip circle center with those settings already dialed in. But again, go through here and, you know, make that size, you know, whatever you want. If I undo all of that, so we just have this geometry, we can go in here to be, again, BI brush insert IMM primitives, we'll grab whatever shape you want. Again, I'm going to pull a cylinder on here, push it through, hit W to move this on through. I'm going to go in here to subtool, split, unmask points. So I'm going to select the cylinder, which is now a different subtool below this. I'm going to set it to subtractive, go up here to live Boolean, we'll turn off polyframe, and you'll see it's a live Boolean. So we can go through here and we can scale this up or down to make whatever size hole we want. If we like this, we can go down here to Boolean, make Boolean mesh. And then there we go. There's our U mesh. There's a hole through our mesh. If we go back here, let's go back here to where we just, and again, we'll turn off live Boolean. We'll go ahead and delete this cylinder out of our scene. Here we go. So we just have plain old geometry on here. So what we can do is we can go in our Z model brush, BZM. You can hold down Alt and you can mark geometry. If we go over here and mark, well, we can actually just push this through. So we can say Q mesh, polygroup all, and just push this through. And now you have a hole, or you can just do it with one piece of geo if you'd like. If you want, you can also say spherize polygroup all, and you can turn this into a circle, and then you can go to the other side here. See if I can remember where this goes. Spherize, and then you can say again, Q mesh polygroup all, and you can push this through. We'll undo that. You can also go in here and you can say split point. So you can split, I will start here. So we'll just split point here and here and here, and we'll flip over to the other side and we'll go back down. And then with these, you can say Q mesh polygroup all. And just push those on through, and you can just model a hole through your object like that. So a couple different ways, Boolean, Z modeler, Dynamesh, depending on what your model is, but just a few ways to punch a hole through an object there.